Hello everyone, welcome to Coding World. So in this video I will show you how to we will discuss about how to create a reactive form and how to bind it. So before going to the video, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and click on bell icon to get the latest notifications, and let us know the leave a like if you like the videos, and keep supporting guys. So coming to the video, as we discussed in my previous video, if you haven't watched my previous video, I will give the link in the description below about the template driven forms. So there are two type of forms in Angular. One is template driven form and the second one is reactive form. So I have already made a video on the template driven form and about the validation, how to give validations in a template driven form. So please check out that in the description below. And coming to the reactive forms, we also call it as a model driven forms. If you think template driven form is in a messy, then go with the reactive forms. But in reactive forms, we need more lines of code, okay, as compared to the template driven forms. As I have already shown you in my previous video, in the template driven forms, it is completely into the HTML part, and even the error message which we show, that too will be in the HTML part itself. By using NGF conditions, we just show the error messages. So I will show you. So this is we need two classes required for creating a form control. One is form group and the second one is form controller. So before going to the video, coding part, I will show you how it works. Okay, first I will open a console, inspect in the browser. So I will clear this. Some random name, header, gmail.com, and name is as usual name. I am giving name of coding one. Okay, I'll open console, I'll clear everything, it's empty. So if I click here, see, it is showing that email and name. So in the same way, we will use a form control for the name purpose, and to bind the data, I am using reactive form. So in the reactive form, it will show us like this. I am using a new form group, and inside the new form group, I'm giving name and email and name, and binding the email and name. Okay, so let us get started into the coding part. So coming to the video part, I will show you in my in the end of the video how I created this card view. So coming to the coding part, we will first start with the form. Okay. We'll start with the form. I'm giving this dot row dot CYL G 12. Here label for email. Come input class. As I said before, we need to use two classes. One is form control and the second one is form group. So form control, the same way here need to give form group. Okay, here, so here we need to bind the data. So reactive form we need to give a particular name to that, as we use in a template driven form ng model. Here we will give as form controller. The name will be changed, that's it. The remaining things are same, and control name is equal to email. I will give a placeholder to this. Placeholder as enter email. So in this way, so I will copy this and I will paste it here below, and I will replace the names here. As we discussed, I will show only two fields, and in the validation part I will show the remaining ones for mobile number, email ID and password, etc. So I will change your name as well as in the placeholder name. Again, I will copy this, I will replace this. We'll give us a class ptn info, custom btn, which I have already written in my CSS. The type is equal to submit. So in this way, and we need to give a form control here, name of the form, form group. Need to give name form group, and I will keep it the name as reactive form. In the same way, we need to mention in the TS file also as reactive form. Okay, I'm getting this error. I don't know why. In the shader part, I will remove this. Let's can give this. Okay. So, okay. And by the way, we need to mention reactive forms module in the nearest app module. Okay, I have already given this reactive form here, have mentioned here, so you guys also need to mention that one. And coming to the binding part, we need to give this dot reactive form, this is equal to new form group. Form group, and inside the form group we will open a email new form control. Form control. In the same way, we will give a name also, new form control. Okay, that's it. So I'll do one thing here. I'll console.log this dot reactive form dot value, because we directly getting the, I mean directly we are consoling the form, right? We need to give the value. We'll save this file, save the code, open the console if there is any mistakes. Okay, ng react form. Okay, it is showing some error. I think the name was not correct. I think so. Have done reactive. Okay, this is a mistake I have done. I've given two different spelling issue. So here it is. Okay, I will give us a coding all at the rate mail.com. The coding all. See, the console, we are getting the data. Okay, so in this way we can bind the data in the reactive form by giving a form controller like this form controller and the name which of the name we wanted to bind. So we need to give a particular name, and inside the TS file we need to inside the new form group we need to give the name and email. So in this way we can bind the data in a reactive form. And coming to the UI part, I have taken a section format section tag. For the section tag, I have inside the section tag I have given a image tag, and for the image tag I have given absolute position absolute. So on top of it I have taken a container. Inside the container I have given a card like this. So this is the card. Inside the card again I took an a this is the card div, and inside the card div I have given a image tag. So again same for the image tag I have given a position as absolute, excuse me, position as absolute. So here I have shown the image, same image inside the card tag. So in this way we can design the UI simply. So thanks for watching guys. Please subscribe to my channel and give a thumbs, and you can discuss anything in the comments below, and please do support.